Hi everyone, welcome back to this MCQ series of Agriculture and Rural Development for the NABARD exam. My name is Pooja Rawat and this is our fourth session in this series. So in today's session, I'll be discussing the important questions related to the seed production, seed processing, all right, a very important part both for your phase 1 and phase 2, right? So before we start, all those people who are here for the first time, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon so that you'll be notified regarding the upcoming videos. And you can also join our Telegram group wherein you can post your queries and you'll be updated with the upcoming videos and the exam notifications. All right. So here is our first question. And it says, blue color certificate is issued for which of the following class of seeds? Seeds have different classes, okay? So we have nucleus seeds, then we have breeder seeds, foundation seeds, and then we have certified and registered seeds. So all these seeds have different genetic purity, physical purity, all right? And based on the purity and their germination capacity, the different colors tag are issued for these type of seeds, all right? So blue color jo tag diya jata hai, certificate tag is given to the certified seeds. Alright. Now here I have listed all the types of seeds and the kind or the color of tag that is issued for these seeds. Alright, this is very important. You have to learn it. Right. Nucleus seeds. First is the nucleus seeds. The genetic purity that should be maintained is 100%. Okay. So the progeny hai, that should have all the traits of its mother seed, right? So nucleus seeds, these are the basic foundation seeds and the genetic purity that should be maintained is 100%. And for nucleus seed, there is no such color of the certification tag, but a breeder issued this pedigree certificate. All right. Now the next is breeder seeds. So nucleus seeds set the foundation for these breeder seeds. So these are used to produce the breeder seeds, all right? Now the genetic purity that should be maintained is 100%. So for both nucleus and breeder seeds, genetic purity should be 100%. And the certification tag that is issued for this class of seed is yellow. So golden yellow in color. Now the next is foundation seeds. So foundation seeds are developed with the breeder seeds. Alright, so this is a seed production chain. Alright, the foundation seed ki jo genetic purity hai, that should be maintained at 99.5%. And the certification tag that is issued is white in color. Now registered seed are made or produced by using foundation seeds. Alright. The genetic purity should be 99.5% and the tag is purple in color. And the last we have certified seeds. So foundation seeds are used for both registered seeds and certified seeds. Okay. And registered seeds are voluntary in fact. I mean foundation seeds can be directly used to produce certified seeds in a seed production chain. Now the genetic purity that should be maintained in certified seeds is 99%. Okay, and the certification tag is blue in color. So this is the class of seed and these are the tags that are issued for each class of seeds and this is a genetic purity that you should remember this. Okay, so this chart should be remembered. Now the next question is, which one is the basic seed class for the entire seed production chain? So basic seed class kaun si hai? Abhi humne last chart mein, the last slide mein dekha tha ki nucleus seeds are the basic of the entire seed production. They set the foundation. These are the foundation seeds. Ek tarike ke. Yeah, humne dekha na, nucleus. Not that the foundation seeds in itself is a class, right? But they set the foundation of this entire seed chain. So nucleus seed is the basic seed class for the entire seed production chain. The next question is, what should be the isolation distance in the foundation seeds of wheat? So we'll understand what is isolation distance is. For now, the correct answer here is 3 meter. Okay. So isolation distance kya hota hai? Let us understand this. It is the distance between the seed crops and the different varieties of the same crop located in the adjacent area in order to maintain the genetic purity of the seeds. Now, इसका मतलब क्या है? For example, this is a field, ठीक है? और आप wheat की दो variety हैं, right? And you are preparing these seedlings. तो यहाँ आपने wheat one sow किया है, and here you have wheat two. Now this is the distance, the minimum distance that should be there between the different varieties of the same crop, right? The crop is wheat, but we are using different varieties, so there should be a minimum distance between them, so that genetic contamination नहीं होना चाहिए, कि cross pollination नहीं होना चाहिए, right? So to maintain the genetic purity and to avoid the chances or possibility of cross pollination, alright? So maintaining appropriate isolation distance avoids cross-pollination and the crossing of genes so that you can maintain the genetic purity. And the isolation could be both spatial, that is the space isolation. For example, this, you're sowing these two varieties of seeds at the same time. So therefore, you need to maintain an isolation distance. Now, isolation could be both spatial and the time isolation. Time isolation mein kya hoga? You grow one variety of wheat and after harvesting it, you'll be sowing the next variety of the seeds. There could be timely isolation, time isolation. And when you grow or sow both the varieties of seeds at the similar point of time, then you will have to maintain a space isolation, the same isolation distance both thing. Now these are the isolation distance for few crops and these are the self-pollinated crops. Self-pollinated crops can be paddy. That is rice. तो उसमें आपको 3 meter का distance है. Wheat isolation distance will be 3 meter. Ragi 3 again and the groundnut में भी 3 again. तो आप इसको club कर सकते हैं paddy, wheat, ragi, groundnut 3 meter. Then black gram and green gram 10 meter. Cross pollinated crops. See cross pollinated crops में distance should be more. So maize के लिए क्या है? 400 meter का distance चाहिए होते हैं. क्योंकि obviously pollen can pollen grains जो होते हैं they can transfer these so pollens जो होते हैं वो basically pollen grains को transfer कर सकते हैं right so maize में 400 meter and bajra जो है उसमें 1000 meter का distance है remember this then sunflower 400 meter the isolation distance between the different varieties of sunflower should be 400 meter so I hope isolation distance is clear. Moving forward, the process in which seeds are placed in the holes or pits at equal predetermined distances and depths is known as what? So seeds, जो sowing आप seeds को sow करते हैं, so there are different methods that are involved in sowing the seeds. Alright, so these could be broadcasting method, drilling, sowing behind the country plow, dibbling. Right, so here the correct answer is dibbling. डिबलिंग में क्या करते हैं आप देर आर स्पेसिफिक डेप्थ के आपके होल्स क्रिएट करते हैं फील्ड में ठीक है तो प्री डिटरमाइंड डिस्टेंस है कि इन दोनों सीड्स के बीच कितनी डिस्टेंस होनी चाहिए एंड द डेप्थ इज ऑल्सो डिसाइडेड बिफोर हैंड एंड देन यू प्लेस सीड्स इन टू दीज होल्स एंड आफ्टर दैट यू कवर दिस विद दिस सॉइल दिस इज द मेथड ऑफ डिबलिंग Now broadcasting method में कहते हैं broadcasting method involves simply the scattering of seeds. So simply scattered these seeds on field or seed floor. Drilling में कहते हैं drilling में there is you sow seeds in a continuous furrow lines. Right? So इस तरीके से furrow lines हैं and then you will be placing seeds continuously. This is a drilling. Now sowing behind the country plows में क्या होगा country plow है that will be moving इस तरीके से so that will be moving forward and this could be done either through mechanically or through manually ठीक है तो person would be walking behind this country plow and he'll be scattering these seeds not scattering but he'll be placing these seeds in the furrow lines अलग So these are the different methods of sowing. Now question number 5 is a measure of the proportion of seeds in a lot that are capable of germinating is what? Percentage purity, percentage germination, crop seed, viability or vigor. See, the ability of the seeds to germinate, is known as viability. Now you have a certain lot of, for example, 100 seeds. See, you have this lot of 100 seeds. Now, how many of these seeds are capable of germinating? That shows its viability, ठीक है, percentage viability. So the correct answer here is viability. Now the next question is, which of the following is correctly matched? So these are the seed class and these are the genetic purity, and we need to identify which of these are correctly matched. First is the breeder seeds or the nucleus seed. Genetic purity should be 100%. This one is right. Foundation seeds, genetic purity should be maintained at 98%. Wrong, 99.5%. है ना, we have read that. The foundation seeds की जो genetic purity उतनी होनी चाहिए, that should be 99.5%. Certified seeds की genetic purity should be 99%. This one is correct. So the correct answer would be 1 in 3. This is the correct answer. Next question है, the seeds should be stored at a safe moisture level of 9 to 13%, 12 to 16%, 15 to 20, 20 to 25, or 25 to 30%. So the safe moisture level that should be maintained while storing seeds is 9 to 13%. The moisture content जो है seeds का वो कितना होना चाहिए, 9 to 13% होना चाहिए. Because high moisture अगर होगा, तो फर्स्ट थिंग जो सबको पता है, जब भी ह्यूमिडिटी ज़्यादा होती है, मॉइस्चर ज़्यादा होता है, देर आर चांसेस ऑफ पेस्ट इन्फेस्टेशन. नहीं, पेस्ट इन्फेस्टेशन के चांसेस हैं. सेकेंड थिंग इज, इट हैज बीन सीन दैट हाई मॉइस्चर कंटेंट इन द सीड लीड्स टू पुअरली अफेक्ट द जर्मिनेशन कैपेसिटी ऑफ द सीड्स. ठीक है, सो इट एडवर्सली अफेक्ट्स द seed germination capacity. All right, that's why the moisture level in the seed or the moisture content should be maintained as low as possible, or between 9 to 13%. Now question number 8 is, which of the following are the characteristics of formal sector of seed production? So seed production involves, or it has two kinds of sectors, that is formal sector, and then we have informal sector. Informal sector kya hoga? Localized production hoga, there would be no mechanization, all right. So farmers will be involved in these informal sector. Jo supply chain hoga, that would be, farmers would be buying seeds among themselves, or cooperatives jo honge choti choti, wo involved honge seed production mein or seed distribution mein, all right. And these are the characteristics of the formal sector of seed production. So let us understand this. First is the mechanized production. So yes, क्योंकि formal sector है, government agencies और बड़ी बड़ी companies जो है, MNCs, that would be involved in the seed production. So the production would be mechanized. So manually possible नहीं है. So it is done on a very large scale, right? The seed production would be done on a very large scale. So there would be a mechanized production. And second statement है यहाँ पे, heterogeneous in space and time. This one is wrong. See, mechanized production जब भी होता है वहाँ पे क्या होगा, homogeneity आएगी. ठीक है, this is a formal sector, seeds are produced on large scale using the machines and all and farm implements, so this is homogeneous in nature. So there will be a uniformity in producing seeds, and the size of seed or the quality that would be maintained, that would be homogeneous with respect to space or time. That's not going to change. The quality of the seeds would not change with the changing time. All right, the third is the quality control system. This one is also correct. So there would be a seed testing facilities at the formal sector of seed production, so that will ascertain the quality of the seeds, the purity of the seeds. The fourth is, it follows seed certification procedures. This one is also correct. This is a formal sector and it will involve certain seed certification procedure, right? So third one is correct. First, second and fourth would be the right answer. Sorry, first, second galat hai. First, third and fourth would be the right answer. D is the correct answer. Now, question number 9 is, which of the following crop has the lowest seed multiplication ratio? Now, let us first understand what is seed multiplication ratio. So, seed multiplication ratio, okay, this is the number of seeds to be produced from a single seed when it is sown and harvested. ठीक है, तो एक सिंगल सीड को क्या किया है आपने, सो किया है, ठीक है, इसको हार्वेस्ट किया. नाउ अब ये सीडलिंग में कन्वर्ट हो गया, प्लांट में कन्वर्ट हो गया ना, हाउ मेनी सीड्स इज गोइंग टू प्रोड्यूस, सो दैट विल डिटरमाइन द सीड मल्टीप्लिकेशन रेशियो. अब इसका फॉर्मूला क्या है, किस तरीके से आप कैलकुलेट करते हैं, तो सीड मल्टीप्लिकेशन रेशियो वुड बी द रेशियो बिटवीन द सीड यील्ड, दैट इज द नंबर ऑफ सीड्स दैट इज दैट, फॉर एग्जाम्पल आपने 500 सीड्स सो किए हैं, सीड यील्ड वुड बी कि ये 500 सीड्स कितने नंबर ऑफ सीड्स जो है वो प्रोड्यूस करेंगे, डिवाइड करेंगे आप इसको सीड रेट से. द सीड रेट क्या होता है, सीड रेट इज बेसिकली दिस क्वांटिटी ऑफ सीड ऑफ द क्रॉप दैट इज रिक्वायर्ड टू सो अ यूनिट एरिया ऑफ लैंड फॉर ऑप्टिमम क्रॉप प्रोडक्शन. ठीक है, सो आपको एक ऑप्टिमम क्रॉप प्रोडक्शन चाहिए. बेसिकली सीड रेट डिटरमाइन करते हैं कि आपने कितने क्वालिटी सीड्स और कितने सर्टिफाइड सीड्स जो है आपने अपने फील्ड में सो करें. ऑलराइट, that is your seed rate. Let us understand what is seed multiplication ratio. So this is the number of seeds to be produced from a single seed when it is sown and harvested. Okay, for example, you're sowing one seed in a field and now it's been it has been developed into a plant. All right, ek plant ho gaya aur ab iske different pods hain. Theek hai, so how many seeds are going to be produced from this plant? That will determine your seed multiplication ratio. And this is determined by dividing seed yield with seed rate. So seed yield, the number of seeds that you have gained, and seed rate is the number of seeds that you have sown in a field in a unit area of land for the optimum crop production. Okay, so seed rate is the quantity of seeds that you have to sow in a unit area. And the seed is the amount of seeds that you are going to get from the sown seeds. Alright. So seed multiplication ratio, I hope it's clear. Now we have to identify which of these has the lowest seed multiplication ratio. So the correct answer here is the potato. So these are the factual question and you need to remember the SMRs of important crops. Right. So potato ka seed multiplication ratio hai 1:4. Then the groundnut ka seed multiplication ratio hai 1:8. Sunflower ka seed multiplication ratio is around 1:50. Brinjal ka it's 1:400. And the wheat is 1:20. Okay, so ye aapko yaad rakhna hoga. So brinjal ka in fact 450 hai, I guess. So correct answer yahan pe hai A. So this is the last question, question number 10. It says, choose the correct statement with respect to seed drying. First is, sun drying is advisable only in the mid-noon when the sunlight intensity is maximum. This one is wrong. Because seed ko hum dry kar rahe hain, seed ko drying kar rahe hain, that could be done either by natural drying or the sun drying, jise hum bolte hain. Theek hai? Or it could be artificial or the mechanical drying. तो सन ड्राइंग जब भी करना होता है, इट शुड बी ईदर इन द मॉर्निंग और इन द इवनिंग. सो मिड नून में नहीं करना होता है, इट इज़ नॉट एडवाइजेबल टू ड्राई योर सीड्स इन द मिड नून व्हेन द सनलाइट इंटेंसिटी इज मैक्सिमम, बिकॉज इट अफेक्ट्स द जर्मिनेशन कैपेसिटी ऑफ द सीड्स. जर्मिनेशन कैपेसिटी को एडवर्सली अफेक्ट करते हैं. सो दिस वन इज रॉन्ग. द सेकेंड स्टेटमेंट है, आर्टिफिशियल और मैकेनिकल ड्राइंग results in the uniform drying within a short span of time. This one is correct. So artificially drying में क्या करते हैं, basically godowns में जो आपके seeds store आपने कर रखे हैं उसी के अंदर आप dry air को with the help of ventilators This dry air is passed through these godowns, which helps in the drying of the seeds. और अगर बाहर ड्राई एयर नहीं है तो आप क्या करेंगे, उसको यू विल बी हीटिंग दैट एयर विद द हेल्प ऑफ ब्लोअर्स, राइट? एंड देन दिस हीटेड एयर इज पास इनसाइड द गोडाउन्स, दैट हेल्प्स इन ड्राइंग द सीड्स. सो ऑब्वियसली दिस इज अ मैकेनिकल ड्राइंग एंड यू आर आर्टिफिशियली ड्राइंग, सो दिस इज यूनिफॉर्म ड्राइंग, राइट? सो इट मेंटेन्स द यूनिफॉर्मिटी इन द ड्राइंग ऑफ द सीड्स एंड इट ऑब्वियसली टेक्स लेसर टाइम एज कम्पेयर टू द सन ड्राइंग. So, second statement is correct here, okay? So, this was all about today's session and there are a lot of topics that are left in this chapter. So, we'll be covering that in the subsequent session. In the next session, we'll be covering the questions related to the seed dormancy and the chemicals that can be used, different methods that can be used to break the dormancy in different crops. Right, so that would be very important session. So stay tuned and yeah, keep working hard, keep studying. We'll see you in the next session.